Welcome, and in this tutorial we'll talk about page layout in LaTeX. Okay, here I have a very simple document. Document class is report. There are two packages, Times for font and Lipsum for using some dummy text. Okay, in document environment there is one chapter with two sections, section 1 and section 2. Alright, now we'll talk about some important settings for the document, such as paper size, page type, page margins, page orientation and page style. Okay, first of all we'll see paper size. Okay, in general, document classes, especially article, report and book, provide these paper sizes: A4, A5, B5, letter, legal and executive papers. Okay, most of the articles, reports and books are designed at A4 paper, which width is 210 mm and height is 297 mm. We can set the paper size in document class option. Okay, for example, I am using A4 paper, so at this place just write A4 paper in square bracket. Okay, in the same square bracket we can also set the font size. Okay, we have three different fonts: 10 point, 11 point and 12 point. Okay, so I want to use 12 point. Just separate this with comma. Next one is about page type. In LaTeX we can use one side and two side options. Generally one side option is used to create an article, research paper and some simple report. Okay, whereas two side option is used to design a report, especially thesis and book. Okay, we have also options to use one column and two column to create a single column and a double column documents. Okay, third option is open write, which can be used for the design of a report and a book. Okay, open write option only works with the two side option. In LaTeX one side and one column are the default options for article and report, whereas the two side, one column and open write are the default options for the book class. Okay, this is one sided report by default, and we can see the difference between one sided and two sided documents. Okay, so just write here two side and compile this file. So here we can easily observe the difference in the margins in two sided document, okay, compared to one sided document. Actually two sided documents differentiate with the left or inner and right or outer pages, whereas one sided documents do not differentiate. Okay, here odd numbered pages are known as left or inner pages, and even numbered pages are known as right or outer pages. Okay, for example, in this document this is a even numbered page, so we can say that it's a right or outer page. Okay, on the other hand this one is odd numbered page, so we can say that it's a left or an inner page. Okay, in LaTeX we must know about inner and outer margins for odd and even pages. Okay, this is very important point. The left or inner or odd side margin for the odd pages is the left side margin of the page, and for the even pages this margin, left or inner or odd side margin, will be the right side margin of the page. Okay, on the other hand the outer or even side margin for the odd pages is the right side margin of the page, and for the even pages this margin, outer or even side margin, will be the left side margin of the page. Okay, so remember this point. For this even page, inner margin or odd side margin is the right side margin of the page. Okay, this one is the inner margin for this page, for the even page, and this one is known as outer margin or even side margin. Okay, and for the odd page, inner margin or odd side margin is the left side margin of the page. So this one is the inner margin or odd side margin for the odd page. Okay, and this one is known as outer margin. Okay, now with the help of schematic we will see several margins. Okay, several types of margins. This one is the page layout. Here point 1 and point 2 are showing paper width and paper height respectively. Okay, a paper has four different parts. Okay, body, text body, header, footer and margin note. This is the text body. Here point 3 and point 4 are showing text width and text height respectively. Okay, and above this header is there, and below text body footer is there, and left side of the text body margin note is there. Okay, in LaTeX there is one reference point which is situated at 1 inch from the top end of the paper and 1 inch from the left side of the paper. Okay, this is the point, reference point. Here total top margin is divided into four different parts. Okay, 1 inch which is a default. Okay, after that 5 point, 6 point and 7 point, where fifth point is the top margin. Top margin is considered from the reference point to the top header. Okay, 7th point is the head height and 6th point is the head shape. Okay, this is the distance between top end of the text body to the bottom end of the header. Okay, and towards the bottom of the text body footer is situated. Okay, this is the 8th point which is defined with foot skip command. Okay, here left side of the text body we can see that total left margin is the sum of this distance 1 inch plus this distance 10 point. Okay, 10th point is defined with the odd side margin or even side margin for the even page, okay. Here point 9 is the width of the margin note, which we can set with the help of margin par width command, okay, this one. And with the help of margin par shape command, which is the 11th point, we can set the space between text body and margin note, okay. Alright, now we'll set a margin. Here I want to use A4 paper, that means paper width is 8.27 inch and height is 11.69 inch, okay. Top margin is 1.5 inch. Actually, this is the total margin, okay. Don't get confused with this length, okay. Don't get confused with fifth point. This one is the sum of 1 inch, this distance, plus this one, and plus this one. So, total will be 1.6 inch, 1.5 inch, okay. Left margin or outside margin or inner margin is 1.5 inch. Right margin or even side margin or outer margin is 1 inch. Bottom margin is 1.19 inch. Head height is 0.3 inch. This one is 0.3 inch, 7th point, okay. And head separation is 0.2 inch. Text height is 9 inch. Foot skip is 0.6 inch. And text width is 5.77 inch, okay. So we have already added A4 option and 12 point font size, okay. Now we'll add two side option. Paper width is 8.27 inch, okay. And paper height is 11.69 inch. With the help of set length command, we can change these margins, okay, which we have already seen in lengths in LaTeX tutorial, okay. So just write set length. There will be two curly brackets, okay. In a first curly bracket, just write these commands, okay. So first I'll write top margin. Here we cannot write directly 1.5 inch, okay, because 1 inch is already defined. So we have to write just this one and plus this one. So this one I am taking 0 and this one I'll define, okay. So I'll take 0. Next one is head height. And this one is 0.2. So total sum will be 1.5, okay. 1 inch is already defined, plus 0 plus 0.3 plus 0.2. So total will be 1.5 in the top margin, in total top margin. Next one is the text height. This one is 9 inch. Now let's see total length. 1 inch is already defined, plus 0 plus 0.3 0.2 plus 9. So total will be 10.5, okay. Actually, this is total height, so just write total height. Here paper height is 11.69, so total sum should be 11.69. So let's see rest of the height. 11.69 minus 10.5. So this one will be 1.19, okay. So 1.19 inch will be the total bottom margin, no need to set, okay. We can also set the foot skip. This is 0.6. Now we will set the total width. First one is outside margin. Here outside margin is 1.5 inch, okay. Again, this one is the total left margin. So here we cannot write 1.5. As you can see that 1 inch is already defined and this one we have to set only. This one from this line to this line. So we have to only write 0.5. Next one is text width, okay. This is 5.77 inch. Now we will see total sum, okay. Here 1 inch is already defined, so just write 1 plus 0.5 plus 5.77. So here total sum will be 7.27 inch, okay. And rest width we will see. We have 8.27 inch total paper width. So here we have set this one, 1 inch plus this one and this one, text width. And the rest of the length is 1 inch, which we don't need to set because this one automatically will be set, okay. We can also set the even side margin for the even pages, okay. So for even page, if we set this value at 0, this value, then total margin will be 1 inch. That's what we want, okay. So just write here 0 and compile your file. There is a spelling mistake, okay. Just remove T. Alright, so this is the final margin which we have set, okay. For two-sided document, we can also use open right option, okay. In this case, new chapter will start from the odd page, okay. This is the odd page. Alright. We can also set the all margins with the help of a geometry package. which is the easiest way. Okay, so just write here geometry. Here in a square bracket you can set all margins. Okay, so for top you can write 1.5, bottom margin we can set directly. Okay, for outside margin or left margin we can use left or inner option. Okay, even side margin or outer margin we can set with the help of outer option. We can also set the head height and head shape, and then just compile your file. So same thing we are getting. Okay, now next point is page orientation. Okay, there are two types of orientations, portrait and landscape. If a page is oriented vertically then it is known as portrait, otherwise if it is oriented horizontally then it is known as landscape. Okay, so by default this is the portrait page, and if you want to use a landscape page then you need to just pass this option into the document class. Okay, we can also use one package for this which is known as PDF Lscape. Okay, now here at this place I want to use one long table. Okay, here we can see that this table is going out of the margin, so for this table we can use a landscape page. Okay, so just use a landscape environment. Alright, so this one is the landscape page. Okay, we can also use a rotating package. Rotating package provides a sideways table environment, so just use here sideways table to rotate the table. Okay, alright. Now last point is about page style. We have three types of page styles: empty, plain and fancy. Empty page style clears the header and footer, whereas plain page style clears the header and it prints the page number at the center, and fancy page style prints the header and footer both. Alright, so for fancy header and footer we'll use a fancy HDR package. Okay, just write here fancy HDR. If you are using geometry package then you must include this package after geometry package. Okay, after this just write page style fancy for the default page style. At each page we can see fancy header. Alright, here I want to print a page number at one side. Okay, so for this we can use fancy head command. So here in a square bracket we can set the position, and in a curly bracket we can set the header. Okay, for printing page number we have to just use the page command, and we can set the positions. Okay, the available positions I am writing here. We can use E option for even page, O for odd page, L for left side, C for centered or for right side. Okay, for example if I write CO that means center of the odd pages. Okay, and if I write RE that means right side of the even pages. Here I want to use RE and LO options. Okay, right side of the even pages and left side of the odd pages. One more command we must use, fancy HF. Okay, actually this command erases all the styles. Alright, so page numbers are coming as you can see here, but section title and chapter title are not coming. For printing chapter heading just use left mark command. Okay, here I want to use LE. LE means left side of the even page. And for printing section heading just use right mark command. Okay, RO means right side of the odd page. Alright, here we can remove uppercase style. Okay, so just write here no uppercase. Alright, here we can also remove chapter label. We can only print chapter number and chapter title. Okay, so for this just use renew command at this place. Actually this style is formatted with the chapter mark command which is already defined. We need to redefine. Okay, so just write here chapter mark. Similar to this we can also change the style of section heading. Okay, For this we have to redefine section mark. Okay, there are two important commands which we will use here. These are the mark both and mark right command. Okay, with the help of these two commands we can change the header style at any time. Okay, we'll see one example. At this place I want to use only one side. I want to print my header. Okay, so as you can see that section heading has been changed. Okay, in a first curly bracket just use tag 1, and this one I want to leave as a blank. Okay, here there is one argument, so at this place just write 1. For the section mark we need to write a mark right. Okay, now this time as you can see that chapter label and chapter number are not coming. Okay, if you want to print chapter number then just use the chapter command at this place. All right, here as you can see that one section heading is very long, which is not looking good. So here in a square bracket you can use your short title. Okay, all right, here as you can see that fancy header is coming at the blank page which we don't want to print. Okay, so for this we can use empty page package. Okay, all right, we can also change the head rule width with the help of renew command. Just write backslash head rule width. In a second curly bracket just write width. Okay, and we can also remove, just use 0 point. Similar to fancy page style we can also use empty and plain page styles. Okay, for example I want to change the page style, default page style. We can write page style plain. So in this case header will not come. Okay, we can use empty. In this case both header and footer will not come as you can see. For a single page you can use this page style command. Okay, actually this command you have to use after a chapter title. Okay, alright, so page number is not coming at the first page of the title. This command we can also use for fancy and plain page styles. Okay, alright, so that's all for today and thanks for watching.